It's Monday, the second day of August, and our trash bins have been delivered. There's green for yard trimmings, blue for recyclable plastic, glass, etc., and black for garbage. There's the sign that says the house was for sale. That's the road. Across the street, hidden in the trees, is one big house. And over there, on the hillside, you can see several other big houses. Oh, look. Somebody has a trailer up there. How quaint. Up on the hill, there's an old trailer up there next to the old house where I used to know people who lived there 60 years ago. But down the hill, closer to us, is a great big house. It's huge. There's a bunch of rooms over there. And there's more rooms over there. And it's one of the big ones around here. But as you can see, across the street doesn't quite equal next door. Up there, is one of the biggest in the neighborhood. It is monstrous. Just look at it compared to its little neighbor there. There's the neighbor house, which is a good size house. And there's the big one. Wow. That's one of the biggest around here. And it's up on the hill. It's got a good view. We don't have a view, except, of course, if you look up, you can see the hills. I came out here specifically to see if our trash bins have been delivered and if I have to move them. And I can see they're here, and they're safely off the street with room for a car to get by. So this old man is not going to walk any further down this hill. I've just come down enough to see what's going on. These are our old olive trees. They've been here since around 1960. And while I zoom in and out and use up the battery, this little piece of ground down here goes all the way. This is the danger spot here where cars fall off and break their suspensions. All along the edge of the driveway is this area. And down there you can see, just begin to see through the trees. There's more land down there. I'm not going to go down there today. My lungs are still old man lungs. And I'm almost falling down just standing on this slope. Pitiful. Really pitiful. But maybe living here, I'll start to get a little more exercise. You think? Well, I thought I'd videoed enough, but then when I got back up a few feet up to the top of the drive, I realized that I could show you what we call the lower lot. This house, see the hillside? This house was built. There's the steep part of the hillside. And there's the cutaway part where they blasted to push all the dirt out and make a flat space to build a house, which left a slope going down to the bottom of the canyon, which is basically what this house is built on the bottom of the canyon. Excuse me, on the side of the bottom of the canyon. Now, I am not going down those steps, but I do want to show you the magnificent. That big tree over there is in our neighbor's yard. And the pile of wood is in our neighbor's yard. Yes. That tree. That's in the neighbor's yard. And that fruit tree. The line is the edge of all those weeds there before the trees. Then it's his yard. And he's got a similar situation. You see the slope goes up to the left where his house is built. He's got a nice little fenced area there for the garden to keep the animals out. It doesn't work, of course, because the real problem with a garden here are the rodents, the rats and the gophers. And they go under the fence. Of course, you can dig down, build a fence underground, but they'll just dig deeper. This is what, when I was a kid, my parents and my brother and I, we called this part down there the lower lot. We always daydreamed about building a house down there, but we can't, because that's where the drainage field for the sewage is. We have a septic tank over there along the hillside. Jeez, I've got to get these bushes trimmed or there'll be a fire. Look at all that dead wood there. That's very bad. That's going to cost a pretty penny to hire someone to clear it away. Well, anyhow, it's got to be done if we don't want the house to burn down. And we don't want the house to burn down.